Welcome to all of you present here on behalf of Sanskriti School of Engineering. Respected Chairman Sir, Mr. Vijay Bhaskar Reddy Garu, a Sanskriti group of institutions, and a respected Principal Sir, Dr. A. Senthil Kumar Garu, I welcome you, sir. I would like to express our gratitude to our esteemed chief guest, Mr. Sabaraj Arya from NIT Surat, Gujarat. So, sorry. SV National Institute of Technology, Surat, Gujarat. Sir received the Bachelor of Engineering degree in Electrical Electronics from Government Engineering College, Jabalpur in 2002. Master of Technology in Power Electronics from Motilal National Institute of Technology, Allahabad in 2004. And PhD degree in Electrical Engineering from IIT Delhi. So he is joined as an assistant professor, Department of Electrical Engineering, Sardar Vallabhbhai National Institute of Technology, Surat, January 2019. He promoted as an associate professor in the same institute. His field of interest include power electronics, power quality, design of power filter, and distributed Hello? Power generation. Yes, sir. Yes. He received two national awards, namely INAE Young Engineer Award from Indian National Academy of Engineering and Power System Award from Power Grid Corporation of India. In the year of 2014, for his research work, he is also received Amit Gaur Memorial Research Award 2014 from IIT Delhi from the High Impact Publication in a Quality Journal during the section 2013-14. And present, he has published more than 100 research papers in international journals and conference in the field of electrical power quality. He also served as an associate editor for the IET UK Renewable Power Generation. So, Dr. Sabaraj, sir, I welcome you, sir, for express our gratitude to our chief guest. So, who has accepted our invitation to preside over this webinar? So, I welcome you, sir. Sir, are you audible, sir?
Hello.
Hello. Hi. Sir.
Now we can yes, start, sir. Sir, thank you for introductions. And today we are going to discuss something about these design of power devices, custom power devices. So, before that, I will thank to organizer for the opportunity to. Today with the lecture, expert talk in the area of custom power devices. Now we are going to start this one. So, okay, in this case, how we can say? Okay, so in this case, generally we are going to take three types of custom power device. One is shunt connected, second one series connected, third one the shunt and series. Means, whatever supply line we have, distribution system, in that system, we need to compensate power loss created by the load. In load side, we have a distortion, unbalance, reactive power demand due to unbalance in neutral current also. That depends upon the load conditions, voltage dip. Also, you can, this is one side. Second side, also maybe we can observe power loss in supply source. Maybe you have a voltage sag, voltage swell, unbalanced, distortion, those points. So these we will compensate with the help of shunt and series connected custom power devices. If we have a both power, then we can use combined solutions. So now you can see in case of shunt, so shunt is going to compensate only current based power quality problems. Series is going to compensate only voltage-based power quality problem. Shunt and series means that device is going to compensate both type of problem. Okay. So here, so that DISTATCOM is an improved version of shunt active filter, which is used for mitigation of current-related power quality problems. It belongs in the category of custom power devices are that their connection is instant manner. It is capable of mitigating unbalance, distortion in power factor and zero voltage mode created by the load. It is operating in PWM switching. Means we are going to operate switching based on the PWM only, medium switching frequency range. So now you can say advantage compared to passive filter, we have somewhat advanced, you can say, features and improved response also, dynamic response also improved, capacity of target overload, even at reduced voltage level also. What are the function? Harmonic elimination, reactive power compensation, load unbalance, load balancing, and neutral current cover. These are the functions. Then mode, power factor of supply sources maintained to unity after compensation, but PCC voltage drop from related value due to source impedance and load demand. If voltage is going to dip due to related source impedance and load demand, you can see. Voltage regulation also you can observe, but in this case, if we are going to do the voltage regulation, you have slightly leading power factor compared to PFC mode. Because we need extra reactive power to regulate the whatever PCC voltage we have after loading. For that one, we need some extra reactive power. For that, we need extra leading currents. After that, performance depend on control, gauge signal, design of power circuit. So objective maybe you can say, here we will discuss something about the design of power circuit. After that, design of the control circuit. First, we will see some control. So starting, we are going to discuss something basic control. Okay. So we will discuss how we can set up controllers. So maybe time required for estimation of active and reactive power component and their generation of reference current, use of intermediate filter in control logic, independent control in all three phases. If we are need that those type of things, then we can use single phase PQ theory. Otherwise, we can use least mean square method, adaptive filters, and many other controllers. Okay. After that, advantage of control algorithm means high speed convergence, independent control in all three phases, structure of control algorithm based on the basic arithmetic operation. Due to this reason, they are implementing software somewhat easy, you can see. Here you can see basic circuit diagram. Suppose we have taken one four leg system, a four wire system, you can say. This is a supply source. We have a three single phase load. Means three single rectifier and on count point we have created, or that count point have a neutral current. At that one, maybe we can connect to transformer neutral. And after that, whatever wire is coming, that one you can connect to towards supply. But maybe we don't have a supply point. So simply you can get transformer neutral and load neutral at a point. Then if a transformer neutral and load neutral both are anti-phase, then we can understand our system is going to compensate the whatever neutral current is going to demand from load, that current is coming from transformer side in anti-phase manner. And after compensation, we have a zero neutral current. And what other three powers are there? Maybe reactive power, harmonic, unbalancing, those we can compensate by this three leg converter. Okay. And here, how we can design three leg converter? This three leg converter plus RC filter plus inductor, those known as the discrete configuration. Here, three leg converter is responsible to supply the required capacity current based on the power flow. Okay. So, first point is based on the power flow as well as the DC link. So whatever DC link voltage we have VDC, that one, how much we can maintain? We can maintain at least peak value of line to line voltage. Whatever line voltage here we have, so more than that we should maintain here. And for sufficient operation, you can take nearby some round here value. Okay. So, and RC filter, why we want here RC filter? RC filter, with the help of RC filter, we want to remove the whatever ripple current or whatever high frequency noise you are going to adjust due to switching of the converter. And those high frequency noise you are going to superimpose with line voltage. And to provide the path of that high frequency noise, we need to connect on RC filter. Now RC filter is going to provide high low impedance path at half of the shooting frequency. From that way, this is more effective. At fundamental frequency, this one is going to provide high impedance path. Okay. And transformer, you can see that we have transformer, we are going to compensate the neutral current. So you can see primary side we have put delta, secondary side we have put delta. So whatever third harmonic you are going to adjust as a neutral current, that one is going to circuit inside the delta only. That will not go anywhere. But this is one thing. Means we need to neutralize somewhere, now then we need to change the topology of that convert, that transformer. Again, after that, we need how we can design the control logic here. So we need to sense some parameter. So supply current you can sense, load current you can say, supply voltage you can say, DC bus voltage you can say. So load current after sensing and after sensing supply current, we can find out the required reference current based on the whatever algorithm we have designed. Here we can see, here we have used single phase PQ theory. The single phase PQ theory you can see. Simply you can observe whatever any paper up to books, na, in that place they have given this algorithm. So you can see supply voltage, we can find the alpha component. After 90 degree lead, you can put beta component. Okay. So one is the alpha, a second one beta. So we can find out, you can find out the individual three phase power PLA, PLB, PLC. Then you can pass through the low pass filter. Then then all three add. After adding, you can do 1/3. Then you have a average power. So why we want 1/3? Because we want to maintain the load balancing phenomenon. Then output of that one add with output of DC bus PIA. So you can have a VDC, then VDC reference, then you can regulate that value, then you have PDC. Both you can add, then calculate the value of IAP, IBP, and ICP. Means find out the reference active current. Similar case, I alpha ABC, you can shift 90 degree, I beta ABC, we are going to get, then QLA, QLB, QLC. You can find out the value of these three powers. Then you can put low pass filter. After putting low pass filter, you have a whatever value you have. That value you can add. Then you can put 1/3. Then you can put QLA. The QLA plus QQC. Both you can add. After adding, you have a reference reactive current, reference reactive current. You can add, then you have a total supply reference current. ISA star, ISB star, ISC star. And in how we can get output of that QQC, that is we can put set value of reference VT. VT star you can put, then compare with VT, then you have PI controller, then you can regulate, then you have a QQC. After that, whatever ISA star, ISB star, ISC star, then those you can compare ISA, ISB, ISC. After you will get error, with the help of that error, we can generate the gate signal of 3-leg voltage source converter. Then those things you can see here. VSA, V alpha A, V beta A, 90 phase shift. I alpha A, then I beta A. With a voltage current, you have a 5-degree delay. Okay. In that way, we can find out V alpha, V beta, V alpha, V beta, I alpha, I beta. Between V and I, you have a 5L phase shift. You have this. After that, simply you can follow this formula. We have a value of the reference current. These are fixed formula based method. If you have iteration based method, then have some other features. After that, again you can see what error you are going to get. Now that error you can amplify. How we can amplify? After putting PI controller in the error component and compare with 10 kilohertz carrier signal. 10 kilohertz. Now you can see how that one, whatever we have done means that also we can prove by simulation also. So 415 volt we have taken, 160 volt we have done implementation work. So we can see here simulation. You can see. Hello, in PFC mode you can see supply voltage, supply current, and load current. Since we have three single phase load, you are going to have 40% distortion. That one we have compared to 3.8. Same time, due to RC filter, we have got the voltage harmonic near to 2.6. Then you can also you can see that we have zero voltage in PFC mode. You can see supply voltage how much 337.9, but in ZVR mode 339.7. With 2 volt in terms of amplitude, we have compensated. And also we have maintained distortion less than 5% according to IEEE 1519. Now you can see in the hardware also, we have tested these systems. And since we have taken 160 volt line to line, then due to loading 6.53 ampere we have put load. Then you have got the 152 volt voltage D. So your distortion to 32%, 37%, 33%. Come down to 4.5, 4.4, 4.3. Then with your load currents, then compensating current, you can say transformer neutral and low neutral current, then supply voltage harmonics, 3.2, 152.2% volt, you can say. Unbalancing phenomena, how we can observe? Three phase load are there, two phase, in two phase we can observe load, in third phase that value is zero. Then you are going to see the compensating current, see supply voltage balance sinusoidal. That is our objective. That we want.
Next point. Sir, continue.
Next point is now you can see also we need to see a dynamics. Mean during whatever rate we are getting now, if we are going to change the load, then what type of other condition, other parameter are going to vary? So supply voltage, our three phase current. This one is going to show the load balancing phenomena. Our load is unbalanced, but supply is going to see balance. Also, you can see capacitive current, all three phases, means do load change, what type of change you are going to observe in case of mean converter output concept, you can see. DC link voltage, ISC, IEC, and ILC. Supply voltage, load current phase C, neutral current, doing balance and unbalanced condition. Then you can see, transformer neutral and load neutral, both are equal and opposite. Due to that one, we are going to observe supply neutral towards zero only. Just you can see the waveform, is it prominent? Supply voltage, one load current, then one load neutral, second one transformer neutral. Both are equal and opposite. See, after that, in first case, what we have to done? We have run the system in PFC mode. You can see 152. That one we want to maintain 160. That is voltage, zero voltage regulation mode. Because at no load we have 160 volt. After loading also, I want to maintain 160 only. Due to that, for that one, we need to provide some extra linear reactive power. Due to this one, you are going to see supply power factor leading. You can see here, 0.72 leading here. Because we have boosted 10 volt. 10 volt gate voltage at loaded conditions. That is the zero voltage conditions. Again, we can see some dynamics. Here, conclusion is there. Means whatever control you are going to propose or you have developed, then you can design control based on single phase, maybe three phase, maybe that one. And you can compensate whatever problem you are going to face due to current. Those we have compensated with the help of single phase PQ theory. So this one, maybe you can refer any book. So many books are there. Any paper also you can download. Just you can read. Many things are there. Yeah. And after that, we can apply also, no? Renewable, you can apply solar, wind, hydro. And also you can apply this one for any particular type of loads. Those things also you can apply here. Then here you can see books. Main book is this one. Number 4 book you can see. Akagi book. Just you can download also. That book is easily available in download also. Also, you can download papers. How we can implement this? You can see here for implementation purpose, we need some processor. So, here we, in our department, we have 1104 processor. Also, we can implement in small processor DSP processor 2812, and any other processor also, microcontroller also we can apply, depend upon the budget. If we have some less cost also, the 50,000, 20,000, 30,000, from that also we can implement those things. But in that case, we have some less facility. Here, my problem is, we can implement these algorithms. If we are going to implement this space, in that case, we have a unipolar ADC, as well as bipolar ADC, as well as second advantage is that if any gain you want to tune, online also we can tune. That is a major benefit. Okay. So see, sensor card also, whatever LEM or whatever you have a ABB sensor, those you can purchase, then you can develop sensor cards based on the processor requirement. So ADD means you can sense the current and voltage, and you can have the system. Also, we need to invert the logic. Whatever gate signal we are getting by that comparison, after that, we need to invert that one to give same leg lower IGBT. So for that one, we need to put one delay circuit, one inverter circuit, you can see. By IC6400, we can develop that one. Also, we need to maintain the delay between same leg to IGBT. In one lane, we have two IGBT, we want to maintain some delay. So that they should not experience short circuit during short circuit from DC bus, you can see. So for that one, maybe we should maintain how much delay time? 2 to 5 microseconds. I mean, 5 to 10 microseconds delay time also we can maintain. Implemented using NAND gate. NAND gate IC 0400. So with the help of this one, we want to get that dead time or you can get delay time. Some places they are in dead time, some places they are in delay time also. Why we want that one? If our switching is going to transfer from one phase to one cycle, one half cycle to the next half cycle, then so whatever overlap is coming between one half cycle to next half cycle, so that due to overload, our DC link going to experience the short circuit. Means both IGBT are going to on at a time. So that we want to provide even that phenomena. Okay. Then after that, also we have converters. We can develop very small converter, 6,000, 2,000, 3,000, 6 IGBT you can take. You can implement that one. Then RC filters also we can make. Then we can record the results. Whatever these are the results only. Then in that way, we have seen the distillate car means we want to compensate kind-based power quality following supply system. Now suppose we have voltage-based power quality following supply. So how we can compensate that one? That is main point. If we have voltage-based power quality problem, what are the voltage-based power quality problem? Maybe we have voltage sink, voltage swell, unbalance, distortion, flickering, notching, those we want to compensate. So for that one, we need dynamic voltage restorer. So this is the advanced version of the sage filter, you can see. Generally, sage filter, by application of sage filter, only compensate the harmonics. But this one is going to compensate set, swell, along with harmonic compensation. Just like what is the distillate comb? Distillate comb is the advanced version of the active filter, shunt active filter. A shunt active filter compensate only harmonics present in load, and with the help of shunt filter, that whatever load harmonics are there, they will not go towards supply side. Same as here, whatever voltage harmonic is there, that voltage harmonic they will not travel towards load side. Along with only voltage, if you have voltage harmonic compensation phenomenon, you can say series filter. If we have a primary working shunt and second swell compensation along with harmonic unbalancing, then you can say that is the DVR. In that way, we can differentiate, you can say. So after that, here again, we have many topology, you can say 3x3 wire, 3x3 wire with capacitor, 3x3 wire with 4 leg, 6 leg, 4 leg, speed capacitor, matrix cover, material converter, many topology are in the literature. but we will discuss one basic control as well as the basic two types of control and how we can on their implementation issues. This you can see circuit diagram. How this one is going to operate? That is also main point. Here, DBI are going to operate three mode. One is the in-phase compensation. Second one, the quadrature compensation. Third one, the some optimal energy based systems. Because in-phase means EPQC, DVRP, DVRQ, DVRS. So that we need to put energy storage system. And how we can maintain the volt, how and what condition this one is going to compensate those problems? If converter output voltage, a converter transformer, converter side voltage, whatever voltage you are going to observe, if we are able to maintain DC bus energy storage voltage more than 2√2, then this VSC is going to work as a voltage compensators. And this one is going to compensate the voltage based power quality problems. Okay. Next. Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir. Audible, sir. Yeah, audible, sir.
Slides coming or slides?
Yes, sir. Coming, sir.
Okay. Then next is. Then you can see based on this link. So what are the main component here? Supply source we have, load we have, no problem. Interface inductor, RC filter, interface inductor, voltage source converter, then DC bus. These are the component of DVR. Okay. After that, you can see four leg means four wire system. You can see here three single phase. You can design based on the this one 3-phase 4-wire. The base on delta star transformer also we can use. Speed capacitors, matrix converter based system, matrix converter, topology based system. You can see. Next, you can see multiple converter also we can apply. And then based on the rectifier supported or based on the energy source. I mean, this is a phase capacitor base or based on the energy source. Are based on the rectifier supported. Are three types of system we can develop. Somehow we want to maintain DC link voltage or energy inverter input voltage more than converter side transformer voltage. A transformer voltage converter side depends. If we have how we can see transformer primary side voltage, so based on the SEGA swell or hotter power side, based on that, you can decide the rating of transfer primary. Transfer secondary side, whatever interface transfer is there, based on the turns, if you are going to take 1:1, then that is also okay, 1:2, 2:2, whatever theory are there, you can take that one. And based on that, you can decide the rating of the DC bus, whatever converter you have. See, that is the points. Then we can say advantage, disadvantage of topology. Then main point is there, this you can see. Here we have three major point. This is a main point. How this DV are going to operate? But in phase, you can compensate what you can get between phase. You can see middle one. Preset means so between some theta alpha angle you have. If you are going to maintain 90 degree between compensating voltage and that line current, then you have a quadrature compensation. So we are going to deal about the quadrature compensation here. So again, you can see we will discuss something. This circuit we have implemented three wire systems. Okay. Here. So in this case, first we can see design. So you can find out transformer rating based on the how much percentage of SEG you have assumed that in that. Then you can, we can set the value of DC link voltage, VD. How much? More than 2√2 VSC. Also, we can design transformer, a capacitor voltage, capacitor microfarad. So simply simple guideline for shunt electric converter. For each 5 kVA, we can take 2000 microfarad. For each 5 kVA, we can take 2000 microfarad. Then after the main topology people have proposed, now you can see, this is the base thing here. So you can see in case of shunt connected converter, shunt connected thing, you can sense load current, convert ABC to DQ, then you can put a LPF filter, then you have a somewhat pure value of ID and IQ component. With ID, you can add the output of DC bus PI. Then you can generate the reference current if you are going to run the system in PFC mode. If you have PFC mode, only modify value of ID we need. If we want to run in ZVR mode, in that case, Q component we can take from that, what a PI output, AC bus PI output is coming, na? That value subtract from IQ component. Okay. Then after that, this is what, after that you can convert DQ to ABC, then you have a reference current. Based on the reference current, you can get the gauge signal using sine PWM or maybe any other special type of PWM technique. Okay. Next is C is in case of series compensation. Compare DC bus voltage, PI, then you have a PI output. In case of DC bus. In case of DC bus system, take the supply voltage, convert ABC to DQ. D and Q have put pass through from low pass filter so that whatever oscillating component are there, na, those we can remove. Then from D component, subtract output of DC bus. In Q component, add the value of AC bus PI. After that, you have modified value of D and Q, convert DQ to ABC, then we have VLC, VLA, VLB, VLC. Though you can compare with actual load current, then you have a gauge signal. Again, point out there, in converse AB to DQ, DQ to ABC, we need information of sine theta and cos theta. Though you can take from load current. If we are going to get the voltage, so load current you can take as a reference. If we are going to get the load supply current, you can take voltage as a reference. Next point is, after that you can see one more control. How you can develop one basic, very basic elementary control, you can see. First, you can sense the supply voltage. After sensing supply voltage, find out the process sequence fundamental component. Okay. Take the DC bus voltage, you put PI, then you can multiply in phase template. Those values subtract from fundamental process sequence component. AC bus PI. PI output you can take, multiply with quarter chain template, whatever output are coming, those you can add with whatever you have got after subtraction from active component from one the fundamental power sequence component. So we are going to see IL, VLA star, VLB star, VLC star. After compare, and in that way, in that voltage control method we can use. Indirect voltage control method you can use to generate the PWM signal. See, in that way we can plot the curves. Supply voltage, you have many problems you can use. This one we have in MATLAB only. Supply nano voltage, sag, nano voltage, swing. Then nano voltage, distortion, unbalancing, those things you have. If we have a normal voltage only, you can see starting start to 0.5. So in that case, VSC is not going to compensate anything. Simply ideal he is sitting, some value is there. We have said that compensating voltage is going to increase. In case of normal condition, you can see, then after that you can see swell conditions, normal, distortion, those things. So due to problems, our output of voltage source converter is going to change. You can see that in point. After you can see load voltage, perfect sinusoidal. Since this is the problem due to control only, the dynamic is not good. Load current you can see. Then you can see VT, voltage, terminal voltage, amplitude, and see the DC bus voltage. Okay, after that you can see how we can say our control are good or not good, then we can state the dynamic response in particular time. After that we can see here, also we have used for tuning the PI controller, different type of optimization technique we have used. Those are the some okay. Then we can see here how we can develop setups for this one. You can see supply voltage, a non-ideal here with the help of inductor, transformer, capacitor. We have developed the non-ideal voltage source. Then here to interface inductor, transformers. Then you can see here voltage source converter. We have to computer. Then you can see here processor. Then sensing element. So with the help of this one, we can generate the. We can develop the DVR in our laboratory. Then you can see this is a processor, those. This is a sensor circuit. Those we have done in our lab only. We have developed the PCB and we have put the, after purchasing these items, we have assembly here. Voltage sensor you can see for this processor. Current sensor, ABB LV25 sensor we have used. This converter we have taken from outside only because this we cannot develop in our lab. These converters. So this one we have taken from Semicron. Then after that, you can see how we can design this input-output resistance. For that one, you can see R input based on the data sheet and value of, based on the data sheet and value of turns ratio of whatever sensor you have used. Based on that one, you can design. Current sensor you can design and you can put OPAM, OP, plus amplifier. Then also you can put Zener diode for protection purpose. You can see this is RC filter. What are we getting? RC filter is a small thing. Here you can see so much capacitor we want. This is transformers. This is the, you can see probes. This is our cabinet. And first floor we have put sensors. Then top floor we are going to measure. This is isolation circuit. What we have designed to interface power circuit and control circuit. This is again transformers and inductor. This is the first one inductor, second one transformers. Then we have recorded results. So you, based on whatever control you have developed, whatever thing you have developed, you can sense the defect intermediate signal and compare sense value and load value and actual value. So based on that one, we have compensated check. After compensation, you can see our sinusoidal balance here, some check is there. Then you can see distortion from 8% to 4.9 in initial stage. Now, whatever testing we have done for EPQC, in that case, we have got somewhat improved result compared to 2-3 years before. This is work done by one PhD scholar. That is a PhD scholar, maybe T and I do. So one person is working here 2 years before. We have done this work. The references. Then we will see something about the EPQC. So EPQC here, EPQC we have, as you can see, one paper we have presented in that paper on that I want to tell. After that introduction that controller results, you can see in this case, we want to solve both problems. Simply we can go towards circuit. You can, this is our circuit of EPQC. We want to compensate with the help of shunt, you can compensate the current-based power quality problem. With the help of series, you can compensate the voltage-based power quality problems. So those we want to, and back to back one comma decision will put, and based on that we can develop the control. This one also we have implemented just before lockdown of this one. We mean in the month of March and April, we have done the experimentation of this one also. We have tested up to 200-300 volt. Okay, in our lab only, because lab also we need. If you have, we have to test this in full capacity, we need that much capacity, that much rated load also. Na? So load, we don't have that much capacity. We are going to run 415 volt or 440 volt, na? We need high capacity load. So that that 1 minute, 5 will not go here and there. So So for that one, we have proposed FTM, FLB-based algorithm, and we have find out the possible fundamental component. Then features you can see. So we, how we can propose the control. So based on that one, we have written here. Means whatever FTM, FLB we are going to tell, na, that one is going to provide angular frequency positive or negative second component. Angular frequency positive and negative sequence component are fundamental component under distorted condition of three phase circuit. It does use synchronous reference frame transformation for estimation of unknown variable as in other PLL. We don't require any synchronous reference frame. Overall, FTM based FL is based on the Lipnov approach rather than linearization approach. Those are the means, you may say some advanced thing we write some paper, not we need to prove some new theory, not some new thing. For that one, we have done that one. After that, in addition, due to selective nature of design, it possesses some robustness against harmonic distortion found in the input source. So after that, we have designed those things. Here also, we have designed Firefly algorithm for tuning of PI controllers. So based on that, we have tuned the value of PI controller, KPKI we have got within 10 iterations, and also we are going to add a value of cost function. We don't want to make to zero, because we want only guideline. With so much KPKI we are going to put, then our system is going to give somewhat effective response. Then you can see DC bus at starting how this one is going to behave, and we have seen that rise time, fall time, and setting time at the starting case. Then you can see this one, simulation result and discussions. So we have got voltage harmonic, how much? Load harmonic near to 5%, load voltage harmonic, supply current harmonic near to 4%. So you can see supply voltage, supply current, load voltage, load current, DC bus voltage, capacitating current, those we have observed. Also, we have done experimentation. So we have put sag, swell, harmonic, unbalanced, those things. Again, we can show the performance series, those things. Now you can see, we want to see the voltage harmonic near to 5%, current harmonic near to 5%. Conclusion, simply we can say we have tested those system and we have got something. You can see here, the PI controller gain, which are tuned by using Firefly algorithm, see minimum DC bus voltage fluctuation, even current and voltage disturbance occurs. Proposed controller of EPQC along with Firefly algorithm compensate the both current and base, current and voltage based power quality problem with smooth, steady state and dynamic response. So source side, TAD in supply, source current and load current, we are going to less than 5%, that we want to see. Here data, you can see. Means whatever data we have done, implementation and theory, we have to tell. References, you can just refer the papers and books. This is the main paper, from there we have got the idea. Thank you. Any question?
Thank you very much. From student side, any questions? Student, anybody having questions?
If somebody want to work in this area, they have some may want to do PhD, those things, they can also come, because we have our college, we have full-time seats also, as well as QIP seats also. If somebody want to come in QIP also, they can apply.
Okay, sir. Nice, sir. So what is the difference between STATCOM and DSTATCOM, sir?
STATCOM means generally we are going to use for transmission line only. In that case, our major points are there, only we want to compensate reactive power. We don't have the harmonic and balance those things. And also in that case, we don't want high frequency switching. Only maybe 100, 200 means 1 kilohertz, 2 kilohertz sufficient. But in case of DSTATCOM, we need have different multiple problems. So for that one, we need some high frequency as well as, means different, their affliction different. here the distribution their transmission lines.
Okay. So anybody having doubt, students, faculty, participants?
And again, we are working in this area as well as the wind, solar, battery charging system. Those areas also we are working. So if somebody wants some help, something you want, they can maybe mail also. They can come also. No problem. Come means they can want to some work. Then they can contact us like that.
Okay. Okay. Sure, sir. Sure. Definitely, we will contact you.
And somebody want to do PhD work or something? They want to do that work. They can also. We have also those seats also here.
Okay. Thank you, sir. So I think it's time to end this section.
Where is this place nearby?
Sir, near Andhra Pradesh, near Anantapur district, sir.
Anantapur near government college. One government college there.
In Anantapur, sir.
One government college, na.
JN2, sir. JN2 college.
I have visited in the year 2009, 98 maybe. That Chitti Babu sir is there.
Yes, sir. So, okay, sir. Okay, sir. My principal also from IIT Madras, sir. Sir completed a PhD in IIT Roorkee, sir. So now sir is working a principal of HSC, sir.
Hi, sir.
Okay. Okay. So I think the section is going to end. So on behalf of Sanskriti School of Engineering, I taken this opportunity to propose vote of thanks for the webinar on custom power devices and design and control organized by Department of Tribble at the Sanskriti School of Engineering. I thank our resource person, Sabaraj Sir Arya, Dr. Sabaraj Sir Arya. We are really enlightened with your knowledge and present about this webinar, sir. It's really helpful for all the faculties and who are all doing PhD work and also our students also. We are thankful to our honorable chairman, sir, Mr. Vijay Bhaskar Reddy Garu, for the motivation towards this webinar. I would like to thank our principal, sir, for his enthusiastic support for conducting a great section. I especially thank that organizing committees and technical team and supporting and coordinators. So once again, thanks to you, sir. Very, very thank you very much for accepting my invitation, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Welcome, sir. And again, thank for inviting me for this so expert lecture like that. I mean,
yes, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, sir. Participants, please submit your feedback. Participants, everyone should submit feedback. I send feedback link in your chat box.
Thank you, sir. Now we can leave, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Participants, please submit your feedback.